Hello, IAL and Thought Leadership News. My name is Jane Morgan. I'm CEO of Plan, Coach, Succeed. And I've been a senior consultant and leadership coach with IAL for about 17 years now. And I'm based near Oxford in the UK. I'm really glad to have this chance to participate in this Q&A with you about leadership in the context of change agility. So what's really important is that it is a road, right? It's a journey and it takes time. So I find a lot of people think, right, I'm going to do agile, and they can see the beginning and they can see the end, you know, and it's a short period of time. But actually, it's a journey that can take a long time to get the whole organization culturally on board with an agile approach. And I think we have to distinguish between agile with a big A and agile with a small A, you know, so an approach versus a whole sort of way of thinking, a whole cultural change. And also the other thing is that agile isn't new. It might be new in terms of the implementation of it, but methodologies, project management methodologies, program management methodologies like PRINCE and managing successful programs have always had an agile approach to them. In other words, you know, you might do a big bang upfront planning, but you always are revisiting and recalibrating and rethinking and justifying the way forward. So it's a bit like quality, where, you know, every decade another version of quality emerges. It's now something that pretty much every organization is focused on, becoming more agile. So I think it's important with any project, any program, whether it's a waterfall or hybrid or pure agile, that you start with big vision. You start with that big context. It's called different things in different environments, but what I see mostly is that upfront, big context, big connection to strategy, the why, yeah, the why we're doing it, and kind of the destination. So it's almost like that lighthouse, that beacon that we're moving towards. That's what's critical. And then we can kind of deep dive. So most projects and programs, the bigger, especially programs, the bigger context are really more of a hybrid. So you've got that upfront, more waterfall, traditional, big picture view. And then when you get more into the development part of the life cycle, then you're into your more pure agile. So that bigger context is so important for people to understand, why are we doing this? Does it make sense to do it? Regardless of how we do it. So that's probably for me the number one tip, is to always set that context appropriately. And the leadership of agile projects is absolutely key, and it starts with us as the leaders. So a lot of the work I do in my coaching is developing this agility within individuals, within leaders. So personal agility, the willing to embrace change, uncertainty, to kind of move, is absolutely number one. Also a passion for what it is that you're doing. So, you know, regardless of whether you're reinventing it a bit as you go, just the basic sort of sense of the vision and also the passion for what it is that we're doing, whatever that program, whatever that project is, sort of visioning, what I would call visionary leadership. And then because of the nature of agile, it's very much around devolved leadership, empowered leadership, a willingness to empower your teams, a willingness to devolve leadership away from yourself, and the skills that are associated with that and with all good leadership. So emotional intelligence, being able to really listen for what's said, listen for what's underneath, what's not said, being able to ask good open questions, so a coaching style to find out what are the challenges, what are the issues, be very practiced in that. also just truly being able to listen, probably the number one thing, and to have empathy for that process, because obviously projects and programs are all about change. The more you're into the transformational change type of program, the more that those qualities become important. But regardless, there's still that need for deep empathy and for just being willing yourself to sort of lead the way when it comes to agility. Okay, so the number one thing is to look after ourselves. So I would say the number one thing is self-care. And self-care is a bit like when you fly and they say, make sure you put your mask on first before you help someone else. This idea of creating balance and being as grounded as we can before we start to go into the work context. So it could be running, it could be yoga, it could be meditation, it could be prayer, it could be whatever it is for you. A daily practice of self-care so that you're always coming into whatever the leadership space is with a very clear, balanced sense of yourself. Number two is to be very clear on your values. And values is a small word, but it's a huge thing. And it requires sitting down and just asking yourself questions like, what's important to me? What's important to me at home? What's important to me at work? What do I love doing? Yeah, the things that you love doing. What irritates me? Yeah, those are our triggers. So our knowing our values and then our values in the context of the organization. And then if you're leading a project or a program, those values, you know, you should be able to see your values somehow mirrored or reflected within that project program space. So being clear on our own values and how we fit, how our values fit with the values of the organization and the initiative is really important. And it can also avoid us being triggered by a value, you know, that's being trodden on. So thirdly, also super important, even though I say, you know, start with ourselves, number three is about being of service. So when you look at how can I be of service, how can I add value to the world, that puts in context everything that we do, and it takes a lot of the fear out of it of, you know, maybe I'm not old enough, maybe I'm not knowledgeable enough, this is a place of uncertainty for me as a young leader, and I coach a lot of young, quote unquote, young leaders. If you look at how can I help, what is the challenge, what is the problem, and how can I help solve that, you'll find that all of that anxiety, if you like, it just drops away. And we then become truly of service. And in the end, you know, that's what it's about. It's about finding the place where we can live our purpose and be useful in the world. So those are the three. Thank you, IIL and Thought Leadership News. I hope to see you all online soon.